I started with a sample of dark gray, just a sample amount works if you get it dark enough, and then I add it to my paint. My paint is shredded coconut. So that's my final transition of this. It's kind of like an ombre, but because I'm painting around the bricks and working it to flow together, it's a little more involved. So I started with a rusty brick, and my other videos show all about that. And then I added a dark gray around the edges, and then I come in with a lighter color like this. Okay, now I have noticed in a lot of the ombre blending videos they use a dry brush, and I've tried that and I really didn't care for that. What I like is just a little wet, a little bit of water on a sponge, and blend it like this, because it's like with makeup. They use the sponges for blenders to blend the makeup, because that is the best way to blend. I don't know. I just don't see the point in a dry brush. To me, it seems like it's just a lot of work and there's more steps involved. Now, if you're going to do an ombre in several colors, of course, you have to get, you know, probably if you're going to do red, white, and blue, you're going to have to get three different colors. But if you're going like from a dark gray to a lighter gray, you only need two colors and some containers and blend it as you go. Now, you have quite a bit of time before paint dries. So if you don't like something, you know, you can just paint over it or let it dry and then paint over it. Okay, so that's my next color, which is not very dark at all. Maybe it should be a little darker. I don't know. Let me try something here. Maybe a little bit darker around there. Yeah, there we go. Okay, a little darker. I want to see these bricks stand out a little more. Okay, there we go. So, I'm going to put the light now next to it, so you can see how I do that. And I'm telling you, sponge is the way to go. Just like with makeup. I've seen them use these on blending makeup, and this really works nicely. I don't know if you remember, they used to do something they call sponge painting, and it works in the same, kind of in the same manner. Okay, so there's part I haven't done, there's the part I have. Okay, so the next color now is not the shredded coconut yet. It's shredded coconut with a little bit of the gray. Okay, there we go. And again, I come in with the sponge. See how nicely that blends that? It looks more artistic. Okay, and if you decide the next step's not dark enough, just add a little more of your darker color. Now, what's going to make this a little difference? You can see the gray now against this drywall mud. Is when I get over here, I'm doing the same thing again. Whereas with ombre, you're going into steps sideways, or, you know. But with this, I'm working around the bricks, so it's a little different. I work out and then meet in the middle. Probably this section, I'm going to meet in the middle with the gray. And then when I get all the way to the side of the area where the brick is, then I will go into the shredded coconut. Okay, so we've got that gray there, and I'm going to come out with that's pretty dark too, but come out with my next gray. All right, and I think I need a little more water, just a little bit, and blend that in now. Love that. I think the outcome's great. Okay, so, and then I'm coming with my next gray a little lighter. And I have something different going here too. I want to give the appearance of maybe like this is an old world wall. Maybe there's a crack in the wall there. I like to get into the art of painting, not just painting. That I painted for many years, so just painting alone is kind of boring to me. So this is fun. Okay, so then what I will do is I'll work that out up until I hit another brick like this one, and then those will blend and be this shredded coconut with just a little bit of gray right in here. Blend it again. I did this technique once with the brick, and I painted it all white, the brick, the wall, and everything, and that really looked nice too. But I want to do something a little different now. Okay, so this has the very dark gray. This is just a little accent I'm doing, coming down like this. Like that. Okay. Come on, my blender. Got mixed up there for a minute. Overlapped a little bit on that, but I'll fix that. I'll just add to it. There. Okay. And when I get all done with this, I will show you a picture. I hope that gives you some kind of idea. But I think the one thing I really wanted to demonstrate was how much easier it is with, oh, a little too much water that time, how much easier it is to use a sponge than a dry paintbrush. It's just, the blend is just so nice.